this is our hotel right here. It's the Embassy Suites where we're staying. It's pretty nice.
These aren't balconies. I think these are like, you can go outside. Oh, these are the...
Of course, downstairs they have shops.
Stairwell. We are on like a super quiet road today, too.
Yeah, Portland in general at night is sort of quiet.
Not too bad.
So we're going to cross across over here.
And this is the entrance to it. Right in here, they got valet parking and the doorman, the whole deal. It's really nice here.
Well, I don't know about a doorman. I think I seen that yesterday, though. So, there it is. There she sits. I'm gonna go inside and check it out.
How we doing?
Pretty good. How are you doing?
Doing well.
As we go in, you'll see they got several Christmas trees right in the lobby. It's quite nice. Beautiful, decorated for Christmas. Up there they have like a convention center area. This is where you check in. They got a little shop right in that area there where you can get like if you need like medicines and things like aspirins or whatever it is that you use. This right here is a table with a lot of plugs, so if you want to plug in like a laptop or something and sit. They got some more Christmas decorations over here and a fireplace and a little sitting area. This is really beautiful lobby. And so they have a wine, chocolates, and cigar store also in the lobby
just inside the door. Thought I'd show that to you.
It's a nice little place and it's right next to where you check in, as you can see. Now here they have some cases, which is across from where you check in, with different awards and things that they've had over the years. They've had 9 different US presidents stay here since this was built in 1912. It's an old historic type of hotel. So you can always check that out. Now we'll get in the elevator and go up to our room. All right, we're on floor number 5, which we are in a king suite. You can see it's pretty nice. We'll go on down here. Jake will let us in. We'll see what the room is like. It's quite beautiful, actually. We've been in last night. This is our second night staying here at this room. Oh, he used it right through his wallet.
Yeah.
All right. When you walk in, we have the bathroom here. Just a basic bathroom, obviously. They gave us a toothbrush, so we forgot to bring our toothbrush. And this is our messy bed that we've already been in since they did make it up nice today. We've got a little desk there, an end table, another end table. Now the cool thing is the lamps here, as you can see, have USB ports in them and plugs. You can turn them on there that way. It's pretty nice. And then we have, which I think we estimated about a 60-inch TV with a wardrobe next to it. Now we go on this way. There's another desk with a white bar.
White bar!
And then we have like a full living room in here, which that couch is a pull-out couch. We know that because inside that dresser right there below the TV is all the stuff to make it with another 60-inch TV. Really nice. So this is room 519, King Suite. Definitely nice. Oh, hi. And they have standard little coffee pot. This is cool, little stackable deal. That coffee and tea in here, cream and sugar, and then the tops, a wine corkscrew thing for your coffee cup, so if it's hot, you don't get burnt. And pretty neat, little ice bucket. Now, if you want to use the water that they leave for you, that costs you $4. So,
We're not using it.
All right, we got our bathing suit on now. We come down, and this is the vending machine.
They got
just outside.
They got Tampax.
So you can either get an energy bar or a tampon in the vending machine. That's pretty weird.
Or
and the standard chips and whatnot. So we're on our way now to the pool and fitness center. This is actually on a lower level, sort of in like the basement, which is the floor just above where we have breakfast, which we'll show you tomorrow when we go do that. And the pool hours are 6 a.m. to
it's cold in here,
10 p.m. Just outside the pool, we have a fitness room here. Got a large mirror right there.
Oh, something else is in there. There's always going to be an infection.
So, got some different than the heavy balls. Some hand weights. It's pretty nice. A lot of treadmills.
Yeah.
And the treadmills have like, looks like, I don't know if they got like a fitness program on there or if you can watch TV on there. I'm really not sure what those do. There is a TV in the corner. So outside the fitness room, of course, like I said, we have hand towels. And here's an elevator that goes down to the pool. So they have this all set up for handicapped people. You'll see in a minute. And this is the area where the pool is. Really nice here. The only thing about the pool area that kind of seems weird to me is this pipe that goes along the roof right here. Seems like they would have made that a little less obvious. Hot tub like that. Now for the hot tub and the pool, we have these lift chairs for, like I said, for handicapped people. We have a hot tub here, and then another one in the back over there, and then the controls up on the wall. And for the swimming pool, we have another handicapped lift to go over there. So it's actually quite nice. Now outside of the pool area, we have some chairs and different stuff. Now this tile we find to be a little slippery. And as you go on down, you see up there is where the fitness room is at the top, and then you come down a level to the pool. And then there's another level that you go down. The stairs are carpeted, so you don't have to worry about slipping. But the rest of the tile in this place is very slippery to me. So when we're around the pool, I think it's crazy. And then when you come down this little hallway alongside of the pool, they have a sauna here. And it's just like any other sauna. So I take it back. The lady actually had just left out of the sauna before I got away. So we're able to come in and see. It's nice and warm in here. So typical cedar benches and cedar walls. And right now it says the temperature in here is about 100 degrees, just a little less than 100. And I'm not sure what that other dial is. I'm going to guess it's maybe humidity.
That's why she got the water, because she was pouring it over the top.
I don't know, maybe. So come on around here, and there's a couple bathrooms. And that's it. That's all there is to it. So we're going to take off. And tomorrow morning, we'll show you the breakfast area. Because it's quite nice in the breakfast area.
Right, so here we are for breakfast. We got coffee and tea. And they have cocoa where you can put either real chocolate pieces in there or marshmallows. Some different creamers with half and half. Then your normal honey, sugar, sweet and low, and equal. Here they have a lady that is making omelets to order. Here they have a toasting station. It's one of the rotating toasters. You can use a traditional toaster if you like. And you have the different jellies, peanut butter. Not sure why there's salt and pepper here. Oh,
somebody. And they have muffins,
English muffins,
donuts, and some danishes. Here they have the hot foods. And here, got sausage and bacon. A little candle burner thing on. Bunsen, I forget what those things are called. Here we got potatoes. This is a turkey bacon, which is really weird. It's like so fake looking to me. And there's some eggs in here. I see some scrambled eggs. Over here we got fruit. Some really nice stuff, some apples and some really fresh looking grapes. Honeydew and cantaloupe. Around over here, we got chia seeds, flax seeds, brown sugar, some apples, some pumpkin seed, some raisins, which goes with the oatmeal that's in here. And there's some hot syrup. And that is for the, oh, French toast this morning. Yesterday they had pancakes in there. Sort of French toast. I'm in the middle of all of it with this bread that you could take over to the toasting station. It's kind of odd to me that it was in the middle, since from here the toasting station is way over there where Jake is. In the background you can see. But I also got some yogurt here and some Greek yogurt along with different items. I'm not sure what this is in the middle. I think that's some sort of candle, actually. If you got some chocolate and raisins and peanuts and marshmallows and stuff to go in with your yogurt. Interesting. Now for drinks, you get the typical sodas. Here's the glasses for the drinks. We have a juice station here that has cranberry, citrus peach, and then apple juice and orange juice. Quite nice. And one of the great things that I would say lastly is that it's awesome to have real plates and real cups for having breakfast rather than all the plastic stuff that you throw around.